Welcome to HIV Community Link's educational video on immigration and HIV. Immigration is a foundational cornerstone that has shaped Canada into the country that it is today, a country that celebrates multiculturalism and diversity and has a global reputation for welcoming people from around the world. In fact, 1 in 5 Canadians consider themselves immigrants, meaning that they have or currently are landed immigrants or permanent residents in Canada. Although Canada's immigration population continues to grow, the immigration process itself is complex, and navigating Canada's immigration system can be challenging. In this video, we'll talk about how Canadian immigration legislation applies to HIV, focusing specifically on the immigration medical examination. As part of the immigration process, the majority of immigrants who are applying for temporary or permanent residency or refugee status are required to complete a medical examination. While applicants for temporary stays of 6 months or less do not require immigration medical examinations. An immigration medical examination is required to establish the medical diagnosis of the applicant. And this includes a physical examination, mental examination, review of past medical history, laboratory tests, diagnostic tests, and a medical assessment of the applicant's records. An immigration medical examination may occur either in Canada or in the applicant's country of origin, and are completed by the Government of Canada's designated panel of physicians, located in the country where the examination is taking place. Physicians who perform immigration medical examinations are responsible to provide the results of medical examination to Immigration, Refugee, and Citizenship Canada. They are not, however, responsible for assessing the applicant's admissibility to Canada. In 2002, mandatory HIV screening was introduced as part of the immigration medical examination. HIV screening is mandated for anyone immigrating to Canada over the age of 15. For applicants younger than 15 years old, there are a few exceptions where HIV screening is required, such as if the child has received blood or blood products in the past, or if they have a parent living with HIV. Can someone living with HIV immigrate to Canada? Aside from the mandatory HIV screening requirements, Canadian legislation, which does not specifically mention HIV or AIDS, does not exclude people living with HIV from entering Canada. An individual can, however, be denied a visa or refused entry into Canada if they are expected to cause excessive demand to the Canadian health and social system. In order to limit Canada's publicly funded health and social services expenses, applicants who are expected to place an excessive demand to the health and social system could be denied entry into Canada. This excessive demand criteria is based on the estimated average cost for health and social services in 1 year. As the cost for health and social services needed to care for a person living with HIV are expected to be higher than the average, the Minister of Immigration, Refugee, and Citizenship Canada announced in 2018 that the threshold for the excessive demand clause for applicants living with HIV would be raised by 3 times the average annual cost for Canadians, raising that dollar amount to almost $20,000. It is anticipated that the average annual health and social services costs for most applicants living with HIV will be under this threshold. However, some applicants living with HIV may have health and social services demands higher than the revised threshold and may be considered medically inadmissible to Canada. In this situation, the applicant can contest the Immigration, Refugee, and Citizenship Canada's findings. Since the process is quite complicated, it's important to seek help from a lawyer in Canada who specializes in immigration law. Medical inadmissibility to Canada. Medical inadmissibility to Canada does not mean the individuals are banned from entering Canada. They are able to obtain a temporary resident permit for a specific period. The temporary residence permit is issued for the reunification of the family, in order to bring in a highly skilled worker, or to allow a person access to medical treatment that is not available in their home country. And in this situation, the cost of such medical treatment would not be covered by the government. Disclosure of HIV status. Canada does require disclosure of HIV status for people who have tested positive during the immigration medical examination. The results of a positive status are shared with Immigration, Refugee, and Citizenship Canada, the public health authority of the province or territory that the applicant will be residing in, and if the examination was carried out abroad, depending on public health legislation, the public health authorities in their home country could also be notified. Furthermore, if the applicant is sponsored by their spouse or partner, Immigration, Refugee, and Citizenship Canada will disclose a person's status to their partner unless the applicant withdraws their application within 7 days. Canada's immigration process is a lengthy and complex procedure that can be further complicated by an HIV diagnosis. If you are supporting someone who is living with HIV who is immigrating to Canada, you may want to seek legal advice from a lawyer to help you with this process. Thank you for watching our educational video on immigration and HIV. For a comprehensive list of resources to support with immigration or for further information, please visit our website at hivcl.org.